गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डू द ट्रांसलेशन. यू नो व्हाट इज ट्रांसलेशन? सो सिंथेसिस ऑफ प्रोटीन्स इज नोन एज ट्रांसलेशन. सो दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसलेशन. एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, बिफोर वी डू द एक्चुअल मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ट्रांसलेशन, वी मस्ट नो व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट और ट्रांसलेशन मशीनरी, विच रॉ मटेरियल्स आर यूज्ड इन द प्रोसेस. So first of all, number one is the ribosomes. Then is the messenger RNA. Next, amino acids, tRNAs, aminoacyl tRNA synthetases. These are the enzymes. So children, one by one we will do their structure, that how they are required in the mechanism. Number one is the ribosomes. Now these ribosomes, children, protein synthesis, it occurs over the ribosome. So they are the site of protein synthesis. That is why we also called them as the protein factories. So now if I show you a diagram showing the structure of the ribosome, you will be very much clear about it. Concentrate on the diagram. I hope you are able to see it. Yes, can you see? Okay, now ribosomes, children. Now this each ribosome, it has two unequal parts, small and large. From the diagram, very well it is clear that it is the larger part and this is the smaller. The larger subunit of ribosome, it has a groove. You can see this groove. It has a groove for pushing out the newly formed polypeptide. Whenever the protein synthesis takes place, the polypeptide is formed from the amino acids, and this polypeptide, it is pushed through this groove. Followed. And the same, why it is first there in the groove? So that it is not broken down by the cellular enzymes. It is protected from the cellular enzymes. And the smaller subunit, it fits over the larger subunit of ribosome like a cap. You can see it like a cap. But here it leaves a tunnel. You can see this tunnel also. Here also. It leaves a tunnel for messenger RNA. Here it is mRNA. Fits over it. So it is a tunnel. Now the two subunits, they come together only at the time of protein synthesis. Otherwise, they remain as separate units. And when they come together for protein synthesis, this process is called association. And for that, magnesium ions are required. Magnesium ions are required. And when the protein synthesis is completed, then these two subunits, they separate. And this phenomenon is called as the dissociation. Now sometimes these ribosomes, they form rosette or helical groups during active protein synthesis. When there is too much of protein synthesis in the cells, then they form the polyribosomes. Now you can see, if I say this is the mRNA like this. During, they form a like group, helical groups. So they are called as the polyribosomes. This is mRNA. So they form over the mRNA. So this is about the ribosomes. Now children, first of all, you should know that when the polyribosome is formed, what is its use? You know, it helps to produce a number of copies of the same polypeptide. When there is a large requirement in the cell for the same polypeptide, then these polyribosomes are formed so that many copies can be made. And if I show you the different you can say parts of a ribosome that are connected with protein synthesis, I have already told you a channel is there for mRNA, followed, so it lies between the two units. This is the channel for mRNA, theek hai, exit tunnel for passage of newly synthesized protein. And the most important thing which I want to discuss is the reactive sites that are present on the ribosomes. Now I will show you in the another diagram which are those reactive sites. I hope you are able to see this diagram. try to understand it, children. It is very important diagram. Followed. Now, there are three reactive sites, if you see the diagram. One site is called as the P site or D site. Second is called the A site. And third is called the E site. You can see P, A and E site. Now, P site, P as the name is there, it is the site for peptidal transfer or donor site. When the peptide bonds are formed, then this site is used over here. So it is for the peptidal transfer. And second, A site, this site, it is for the amino acyl or acceptor site. Followed, this site, here the tRNA comes with the new amino acid. Followed, so it is this site, P site, is jointly contributed by the both the units of the ribosomes, whereas A site, it is situated on the larger subunit. It faces the tunnel between the two subunits. And this E site is part of again larger subunit facing the tunnel site, larger subunit. Now, there is one enzyme that is called as the peptidyl transferase, or you can say it is the ribozyme. Followed, peptidyl transferase or ribozyme, and again it is a component of the larger subunit of the ribosome. Smaller subunit of ribosomes has a point, if you see this, they have a point for recognizing the mRNA. Then is the amino acids, children. If we see the amino acids, second point, if you see the amino acids, amino acids. Now, children, there are, you know that hundreds of proteins are formed, so many proteins are formed in a cell, but the number of amino acids, as I told you, there are 20. So proteins there in hundreds. Now, how is it possible? Now, all types of proteins, they are formed from the same amino acids. Again, it is the arrangement of these amino acids in a polypeptide that provides specificity to the proteins. You know that these proteins, they further function as enzymes and hormones. So their arrangement, specific arrangement of amino acids, they help to give them the specific structure. Followed? So these amino acids, amides, they are the building blocks or the monomers of proteins. We call them as the monomers. Amino acids. Well, monomers of the proteins. So they, all these amino acids, they occur in the cellular pool. Followed? So 20 amino acids, I have given you the list of the 20 amino acids. I hope you have learnt it very well. This is very, very essential. Now, number third, children, it is the mRNA. I have explained you earlier also in the previous video the structure of the mRNA. Followed? Now, again, you know that as the name is there, it is a messenger RNA. It brings the coded information. It brings the coded information from DNA and takes part in protein synthesis. So this mRNA takes part in the protein synthesis because it brings the information from DNA, and according to that, whatever information is given by the DNA, according to that, that very proteins are formed. Clear? And the codons of mRNA, they are not recognized by the amino acids, by the anticodons of the, you can say, tRNAs. They identify the amino acids that I have shown you in the structure of the tRNA. So translation occurs over the ribosomes, and the mRNA can be reused time and again in the form of polysome. It can help synthesis a number of copies simultaneously. Okay, number four, children, it is the tRNA. Again, I have discussed this structure. tRNAs, you know, they are transfer or soluble RNAs. And they pick up a particular amino acid, not every. They pick up a particular amino acid at, you know that, which is the end, CCA, or you can say 3- end of the tRNA. Here the amino acid is picked. When this tRNA, it picked up the amino acid at the 3- end, that process is known as the charging. What is that process known as? It is known as the charging. Now the charged DNA, take the same to the mRNA, this charged tRNA. Now it brings the same to the mRNA. It brings the amino acid to the mRNA over particular codons, which is corresponding to the anticodons, and now it can pick up a specific amino acid and helps in the synthesis of the polypeptide chain. Now children, fifth is the enzyme. I'm not going to write its name, amino acyl tRNA synthetase. Now it is the enzyme that helps in combining the amino acids to its particular tRNA. So whenever this tRNA, it is attached to this amino acid, then it only takes place with the help of the enzyme. So, and this very enzyme, it is specific for each amino acid. It is also called as amino acid activating enzyme. So you remember this. Once you have studied about this translation machinery, then in the next video we will do about the translation mechanism.